Presented by ChurchTechU, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to tell how many displays one of the new Apple Silicon Macs supports. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Alan Clifford. And before we get started, why don't you join the over 11,000 other people that have subscribed, clicked on the little bell icon, and also, while you're at it, leave a comment and share the video. So this is a question I get all the time. It comes in two forms, okay? Form number one is the worst kind, and that is, I bought one of the new Apple Silicon Macs, and it doesn't support as many displays as I need it to support. That's a problem because you've already bought it. Now, if you bought it like yesterday, you can return it and get the one that you want. But if you bought it like a while ago and it's past the return, well, I suppose that you could sell it used, but that's going to be a bigger problem. There are ways around that in ProPresenter, but in case you're not using ProPresenter, I just wanted to make this helpful to other people as well. And so, basically what you need to know is, out of the box, every single one of the Apple Silicon Macs supports two displays. Now, some of you might know, wait, then why can I only plug in one exterior display to my Mac? I said two displays, I didn't say two external displays. So, that's part of the thing. If it's a laptop or if it's an iMac, it may only support two displays total. Hey there, aspiring ProPresenter Pro. Are you tired of getting tangled up in tech trouble? Want to impress your congregation with mind-blowing visuals? Well, look no further. Introducing ProPresenter 7 training at ChurchTechU, your secret weapon for unlocking ProPresenter's full potential. Join me as I dive into the world of captivating presentations, smooth transitions, and jaw-dropping effects. From beginner basics to advanced tips and tricks, I've got you covered. Don't miss out on this amazing opportunity. Visit churchtechu.com/free trial for a free month now. Did I mention it's free? And revolutionize your ProPresenter game. Your congregation will thank you. And if you wanted two external displays, then you're kind of out of luck. What if you wanted three external displays? Well, you need to know what you can find, what Mac you need to buy from the start, and there's an easy way to know that. So let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look at this. And so I'm on the Apple website, and this MacBook Air, well, if we scroll down, look at the MacBook Air, notice it says M1, and the name of the chip is the M1. So that tells me that this MacBook Air only supports two displays, the built-in one and one external, two total. This Mac here, the MacBook Air 13 and 15 with the M2 chip, you might think, oh, M2, that's got to be better. No, this also, since it says M2 right here, only supports two displays, including one of those two is the one that is built into the computer. Well, what about this one here? The MacBook Pro. It says MacBook Pro, so that support. No. This one does not. This is the entry-level MacBook Pro, and it also has the M2 chip. But if you want three total displays, the first one you need to look at is the MacBook Pro 14-inch and 16-inch. Not the 13, the 14 and the 16. And notice that after the M2, after the M and then the number, there's a word. Two means it will support a total of three displays. Max means it will support a total of, I believe, 5 displays. So that's good to know. So that's not just laptops. Let's look at desktops here. So the iMac M1, no Pro, no Max, no Ultra, nothing. Just M1, so a total of 2 displays. The Mac Mini M2, the M2 version of the Mac Mini supports a total of 2 displays. Now, since the Mac Mini doesn't have a built-in display, they're both external displays, so if that's all you need, you're good to go. But if you want 3 external displays, then the M2 Pro, remember the word Pro after the chip designation means 3 total displays. The Max means 5 total displays, and the Ultra means even more than that. So that is the Mac Studio that has that. In fact, let's take a look at it just so that, by the way, the Mac Pro up here has the Ultra, so it's going to be the same speed as the Studio, but having the addition of being able to put cards inside. So let's click on the Mac Studio just to scroll down and see the features here. Blah, blah, blah. Okay. So the Max and the Ultra. So scroll. This is very pretty, this website, but this doesn't help me in looking for what I'm looking for, which is how many displays does it support. So okay, the Ultra connect up to 8 displays and 5 with the Max. So my memory was correct. The Max is 5 displays, the Ultra is 8 displays. So all you need to remember is don't look at the name of the computer, look at the name of the chip. M, number, and then nothing, that is 2 total displays. M, number, Pro, that's 3 total displays. M, number, Max is 5 total displays. And M, number, Ultra is 8 displays. Sorry, I was trying to do it with both hands. So that's how you can tell just by the name of the chip. Don't pay attention to the name of the computer. The name of the chip in when it comes to the Apple Silicon Max, whether it's an M1 or an M, I don't know, 21. Not that they've released that as I'm recording that. But that's the way, as of right now, that you can tell just based on the name of the chip. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to TDM.fyi/pro7 and quick. Give me your name, email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Alan Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com reminding you to go out and change eternity.